Okay, so we're just looking at the answers to the recent test. Okay, so the first one, so little b means you're looking at capital B, second row, third column, second row, third column, so the answer is just minus 3. The order of C is a 3 rows, 1 column. B minus 2a, so you had to take b and you had to double that matrix and then subtract, and the answer was minus 1, 6. 6, minus 6, 1, minus 3, 2, minus 11, minus 2. You just do that one. D, can you multiply BC? So B is a 3 by 1. B is a 3 by 3. C is a 3 by 1. So the answer is a 3 by 1. And when you did the calculation, you should have got 4, 10, 3. And the last one, you had a 1 by 3 for D and a 3 by 1. So the answer is a 1 by 1. And the answer was negative 9 when you did the multiplying. Okay, come across. Okay, so the next one just had to do equating terms. So we had x equals y, and you had x squared equals 4. So that means that x could be plus or minus 2, but we have to keep going on. And then we have this calculation, so we've got y plus 1 equals minus 1. So y equals minus 2, which means of those two answers, we can't have the plus 2, so it must be just minus 2. So your answers are those ones. Okay, next one is a little bit harder. So you had to do a squared first, and a squared was minus 1, 2, minus 4, 7. You just have to put two matrices alongside each other. And then PA plus QI would equal P2P minus P minus 3Q plus Q00Q. Don't forget that I is just 1001. And so then we had some equations. So P plus Q equals minus 1. What else did we have? Oh, 2P equals 0. So 2P equals 0, so P equals 0, and so Q equals minus 1. That doesn't look right. 2P. 2P plus 0 equals minus 4. So P equals minus 2. That's my mistake. And minus 2 for P makes that a plus over there, so Q equals positive 1. Okay, moving across. Okay, next one. Got to find the determinant. So the determinant is 2K plus 6. Okay, and then the inverse will be 1 over 2k plus 6, and then switch 2 with k, and then change the signs. So that's a minus 1. And if the inverse exists, then we can't have 0. So 2k plus 6 can't equal 0. 2k can't equal minus 6. So k can't equal minus 3. Okay, next one. Use the matrix method. 2 minus 1, 1, 3 times x, y equals 6, 14. So x, y equals, so we've got to get the inverse of that. So that's going to be 1 over 2 times 3 is 6 minus minus 1, and then do the switch. So it's 3, 1, minus 1, 2. Multiply by 6, 14, which is 1 7th, and then these numbers are that. And so the solution is x equals 32 over 7 and y equals 22 over 7. And that's it. Moving on. Okay, write the system in the form of matrices. So we've got 2, 4, k minus 1 multiplied by x, y equals 8. So that's the first part. For what system have no solutions? So the determinant will be minus 2 minus 4k, and so the determinant can't equal 0. So we've got minus 2 minus 4k can't equal 0. So take that across. So 4k can't equal minus 2, so k can't equal minus 1/2. Okay, and that's that one. And part C, if there is a solution, find the values x and y. So part C, so x, y equals 1 over minus 2 minus 4k, and then we switch the numbers, so we've got minus 1, 2, minus k, minus 4, times 8, 11, and when you do those calculations, you end up with, and we're going to switch the signs on the bottom, make them plus, you end up with 8 plus, so we've got, so we get x, y equals 8 plus 11k divided by 2 plus 4k, and that's the x number. I just changed the signs to make that a plus, and the next one would be 10 over 2 plus 4k, and so you just have to cancel that one down to that. So the y value cancels down, the x value doesn't cancel down. Okay, next one. Okay, next one, transformations or translations. So we've got 1, 0 plus some matrix AB equals 2 minus 1. And so AB equals 2 minus 1 minus 1, 0. And that equals 1 minus 1. Okay, next one, we have to do a reflection and then transformation. So the first one, y equals x. So we've got x dash y dash equals 0, 1, 1, 0, multiplied by 2 minus 3, and that equals minus 3, 2. And then the next thing we're going to do is a rotation in clockwise. So we rotate 90 degrees. So we've got x double dash y double dash equals 0 minus 1, 1, 0, multiplied by your minus 3, 2, and then that equals minus 2, minus 3, and that's your answer. Okay, next one, write down the image after reflection, y equals 2. So if you're reflecting in y equals 2, x dash is the same as x, and y dash will equal 2 times this number, minus y, so it's 4 minus y, so that's the point. So 1, 3 will become 1 and 4 minus 3, which will be 1, 1. Okay, next one. Okay, so we're dilating from the y-axis, so your matrix will be 2, 0, 0, 1. So x dash equals 2x, y dash equals y, x equals x dash on 2, y equals just y dash. So therefore, y equals 3x minus 1 becomes y dash equals 3, x dash over 2 minus 1. Which is just 3 x dash over 2 minus 1. And so the answer is y equals 3x minus 2, 3x over 2 minus 1, which you could then change to general form if you wanted to. Okay, E. So find the rule. Okay, so after the dilation, we've got 1, 0, 0, 3. So we've got x dash equals x, y dash equals 3y, and then x double dash y double dash equals x dash y dash plus 2 minus 3. we've got x dash plus 2 and y dash minus 3. So we've got x plus 2 and 3y minus 3. So that's the rule. Okay, and part B, so we've got x plus 2 equals x double dash, so x equals x double dash minus 2, 3y minus 3 equals y double dash, 3y equals y double dash plus 3, so y equals y double dash plus 3 over 3, which you could change to over to sync by fractions and a whole number if you want to. So then I've got 2x minus y plus 3 equals 0, and so I've got 2 times x double dash minus 2 minus y double dash plus 3 over 3 plus 3 equals 0. Multiply everything by 3 to get rid of the fraction, so I've got 6x double dash, 2 times 2 is 4 times 3 is 12, minus y double dash minus 3, just go to the 3, and then 3 3 is a 9 equals 0, and then just tidy up. 6x double dash minus y double dash minus 6 equals 0, and then just take the dashes off. Okay, moving on. Okay, this is a harder one. So we've got x dash y dash equals a b c d multiplied by x y. So we've got 7 3 equals a b c d multiplied by 2 3. So we get 2 a plus 3 b equals 7, 2 c plus 3 d equals 3, and then stop. And next one is 2 3 equals a b c d 1 0. So that gives us a equals 2 and c equals 3, and then that gives us 3 b equals 3, b equals 1, and 3 d equals minus 3, d equals minus 1. So the matrix A, B, C, D is actually 2, 1, 3, minus 1. So now we've got x dash, y dash equals 2, 1, 3, minus 1 times x, y. So x dash equals 2x plus y, y dash equals 3x minus y. Okay, so then we've got x dash equals 2x, and then we look at the original equation. So the original equation was y equals x plus 4 or x equals y minus 4, depending on which equation we're going to do. So we're going to take the y, so we've got another x plus 4. So I got 3x plus 4, and so then rearranging, we've got 3x equals x dash minus 4, so x dash equals x dash minus 4 over 3, so that's what we need. Next one, I'll change colour, I've got y dash equals 3 times y minus 4 minus y equals 2y minus 12, and then so 2y equals y dash plus 12, so y equals y dash plus 12 over 2, and then we use that. Okay, so now I'll do my subbing. So y equals x plus 4 becomes y dash plus 12 over 2 equals x dash minus 4 over 3 plus 4. Lowest common denominator 6. So I triple that first one, and I double the the next one and multiply that by 6. So 3y dash equals 2x dash minus 20, and then in general form 2x minus 3y minus 20 equals 0. Or y equals 2x minus 20 over 3. Okay, last one. Okay, so I had to look at this. So we had 2x squared minus 2x plus 5. 2 5s are 10, yep. So then I've got x squared minus 2x plus 1 plus 4. So I've got 2x minus 1 squared, and I'll take the 8 out. Okay, because then I've got my 10 back again. So this is y. So then y minus 8 over 2 equals x minus 1 squared. Okay, so next step. So x equals, the last thing we would have done was had dashes here. So x equals x dash minus 1. So x dash equals x plus 1. And the last thing we would have had is a dash there. So y equals y dash minus 8 over 2. 2y equals y dash minus 8. Y dash equals 2y plus 8. So what we have is we have a dilation. So we need a dilation factor 2 from the x-axis, so we stretch the y, followed by a translation of 1 and 8. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so next one, again, we had these ones, so we proved by contradiction, so we assume that it's rational. So we have a over b, so therefore log 2 5 equals a over b, so that's the base, that's the indice, that's the answer. So 2 to the a equals 5 to the b, so left hand is even, the right hand is odd, and that's the contradiction. Therefore, log 2, 5 is irrational. Okay, next one, pretty straightforward, hopefully. Let the first number equal 2m, therefore the second number is 2m plus 1, so 1's odd, 1's even. So the product is 2m, 2m plus 1 equals 4m squared plus 2m, which must be 2 times 2m, or 2 times 2m squared plus m, which is 2 times something, therefore it's even. Coming across, next one, okay, so step one, okay, first term's 1, right hand side equals 1 times 3 times 1 minus 1 equals 1 times 2 over 2 equals 1, so it's true. Step 2, sk equals k 3k minus 1 over 2. Step 3, prove sk plus 1 minus sk equals tk plus 1. Okay, so we've got sk plus 1 equals k plus 1, and then when you put k plus 1 there, you end up with 3k plus 2 over 2, and our tk plus 1 is going to be 3 times k 2, which is 3k plus 1. So that's what we have to prove. So sk plus 1 minus sk equals k plus 1. 3k plus 2 minus k, 3k minus 1 all over 2. So then might be easiest to expand out. 3k squared, 5k plus 2 minus 3k squared plus k over 2 equals 6k plus 2 over 2 equals 3k plus 1 equals right hand side, or tk plus 1. Therefore it's true for all values. Okay, next one, divisibility. Okay, so step 1, 8 to the 1 minus 3 to the 1 equals 5, therefore it's true. Step 2, 8 to the n minus 3 to the n equals 5 times some number, and then I'll just make 8 n the subject. So step 3, prove for n equals k plus 1. So I've got 8 to the k plus 1 minus 3 to the k plus 1 equals 8 times 8 to the k minus 3 times 3 to the k equals, now 8 to the k, oh that should be k there, sorry, equals 8 times 5m plus 3, that should be k, minus 3 times 3 to the k equals 40m plus 8 times 3 to the k minus 3 to the k equals 40 plus 8 minus 3 is 5 times 3 to the k equals 5, 8m plus 3k equals 5 times something, therefore divisible, therefore true for all n. That's it. Thanks, bye.